Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD, is a chronic inflammatory lung disease that causes obstructed airflow from the lungs. Symptoms include breathing difficulty, cough, mucus production, and wheezing. Most of the time, it is caused by long-term exposure to irritants, such as particulate matter or cigarette smoke, and the symptoms usually appear in adults above the age of 40. The two most common conditions that contribute to COPD are emphysema and chronic bronchitis, and they often occur together. Emphysema is where the alveoli of the lungs, which are small gas sacs which allow for gas exchange between the bloodstream and the air, are destroyed. Chronic bronchitis is the inflammation of the lining of the bronchial tubes, which carry air to and from the alveoli. Your lungs rely on the natural elasticity of the alveoli and the bronchial tubes, and thus COPD occurs because of the impaired airflow.
So what is COVID-19? As you may know, the recent COVID-19 outbreak refers to the pandemic caused by the SARS-CoV-2 virus. This virus is classified as a positive sense single-stranded RNA virus that belongs to the viral family of coronaviridae. The name of this family of viruses is derived from the Latin word corona, which means crown, based on how these viruses appear to look like a crown under electron microscopy. To this day, the SARS-CoV-2 pandemic has caused approximately 450 million cases worldwide and more than 6 million deaths. But these estimates likely underestimate the true numbers due to a lack of testing and reporting. Approximately 80% of COVID-19 infections are not severe, and patients tend to recuperate without any special treatment. This is especially true for children and younger adults, although the Delta variant is prompting greater hospitalizations in younger populations. However, the remaining 20% or so tend to develop significant COVID-19 infections. The elderly, especially those over the age of 65 years, as well as people with comorbidities, appear to be at a higher risk of developing severe infections. These severe COVID-19 infections carry a significant risk of death and tend to entail hospitalizations, the use of mechanical ventilation, and admission into ICU to care for the patient. Some examples of known comorbidities or medical conditions that increase risk of severe COVID-19 infections include diabetes, HIV/AIDS, and obesity. In this video, we will be looking at how being afflicted with a common and dangerous respiratory comorbidity like COPD affects the pathogenesis and severity of COVID-19 infections.
There is evidence that patients with COPD may be more susceptible to COVID-19 infection. To understand this, we will look at the biomolecular pathogenesis of COPD and COVID-19. Similar to other coronaviruses, COVID-19 binds to a receptor called angiotensin-converting enzyme 2, or ACE2 for short. Patients with COPD have been shown to have increased ACE receptors in the lung tissue compared to those without COPD. This increase in ACE receptors may alter COVID-19 interaction and thereby increasing susceptibility to infection. ACE2 levels are reduced when SARS-CoV-2 infects the host cells, which can cause increased pro-inflammatory cytokine production, increased vasoconstriction, increased vascular permeability, edema, and lung injury. Furthermore, pulmonary inflammation increases and acute severe respiratory failure may ensue. Patients with COPD are also more susceptible to infections in general, as possibly due to decreased type 1 interferon production or immunosenescence, which is characterized by increased numbers of exhausted T cells and reduced numbers of memory T cells. Smoking may also play a role in the susceptibility of COVID-19 in patients with COPD. Studies show that cigarette smoke was shown to increase ACE2 levels. While these are proposed mechanisms to how COPD and COVID-19 interact, the degree to which altered ACE2 levels affects the susceptibility and severity of the viral infection is still unclear.
Ultimately, evidence points towards COPD as a predictor of severe COVID-19 outcomes. This is described in several systematic reviews on the subject, with systematic reviews being at the top of the hierarchy of evidence. One large review included as many as 59 studies, showing a large sample size. This review, found that COPD increased hospitalization odds by 323%, increased ICU admission odds by 35%, and increased mortality odds by 147%. The evidence for this association is both powerful and current. The implications of this research are that individuals with COPD are a high-risk group for COVID-19 and should be aware of this when making both lifestyle and medical decisions. This is a somewhat new field, and it is important to continue updating oneself on new information about COPD and COVID-19 if this issue is pertinent to you. It is important to acknowledge that this video is for informational purposes only. Ask your doctor for medical advice on the subject.